Now here we are seeing shear force and bending moment diagram for simply supported beam. So here is a simply supported beam given with these loads, 2 kilonewtons, 4 kilonewtons and 2 kilonewtons, and at these points it is acting. So to draw shear force and bending moment diagram for this simply supported beam, first of all, or any simply supported beam, we have to calculate reaction forces. Why? Because so this beam is just kept on this supports A and B, such that because of these loads are acting, we will get reaction forces at A and B. So to draw shear force and bending moment diagrams, first of all, we have to calculate reaction forces at these supports, that is A and B. So to calculate reaction forces, we have to take one thing, that so this beam is should be in equilibrium under the action of force and under the action of moments. So by taking those two points, that is first point is sum of upward forces must be balanced by sum of downward forces to maintain the beam in equilibrium. So here the upward forces are the reaction forces which are developing at the supports, that is RA and RB. So sum of these upward forces means RA plus RB must be equal to sum of downward forces. So downward forces are 2 kilonewtons plus 4 kilonewtons plus 2 kilonewtons. So this we will get RA plus RB as 2 plus 4, 6 plus 2, 8. So this is 8 kilonewtons. So let us take this as equation number 1. And also we have to take one more point, is that sum of moments created by all these forces about any point must be 0 to keep this beam in equilibrium. So let us take sum of moments about A and equate it to 0 to find out reactions at A and B. So let us take the moment created by this upward forces as positive, that is sagging, we know, or it is anti-clockwise. If you take it is positive, the clockwise you will take it as negative. You will take like this way, anti-clockwise, clockwise, or you can take sagging or hogging anyway. Suppose I am taking here the moments created by anti-clockwise forces as positive, or this is sagging positive, we know anyway. So I am taking here RB into is a force and we require moment at A. So distance between these two points is 1 plus 2, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 1, 6. So this we am taking positive, and so all these moments created by all these forces will be negative, because I am taking this anti-clockwise positive and this clockwise as negative, or this is sagging, this will be hogging, anyway you can take. So this is a minus 2 into this distance is 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1 is 5, and next here also it is minus about A, so minus 4 into distance is 2 plus 1, 3, and here also minus 2 into distance is 1 here. So here if you do this thing equal to 0, and if you do this thing 6 times of RB is equals to, you will get this as a total is 24, you will get how means it is if you send all this side, it is 5 into 2, 10, so this side plus, so this is also 4 into 3, 12 plus, and 2 into 1, 2. So we are sending all these terms this side, such that we are getting this value as 10 plus 12, 22 plus 2, 24, and this is 6 times of RB, and here you will get RB is equals to 24 divided by 6. So here we are getting RB as 24 by 6 as 4 kilonewtons, we are getting RB. And here if you take from equation number 1, we can write RA is equals to 4 kilonewtons. Why? Because RB is 4 means RA also 4 to get 8 here. So here we are getting, or we got here RB as 4 kilonewtons and RA as 4 kilonewtons. So from this we can understand that, so friends, if you see here, if you have symmetrical loading conditions and symmetrical simply supported beam, means the loads are symmetrical and here the distance is 1 1, and here 2 2 2 kilonewtons, 2 kilonewtons, and middle is 4 kilonewtons. So this is nothing but symmetrical loading conditions. In the symmetrical loading conditions, we will get reactions half of, means total load is downward load is 4 plus 2, 6 plus 2, 8. So total downward is 8, so reactions will get half of means 4 plus 4. So this is the procedure to calculate the reaction forces. So let us calculate shear forces at different points to draw shear force diagrams. So let us write shear force at B. So before that, let us define shear force at any point or section. Suppose if you take any beam, length of beam like this, or and if you take a point here on the beam, suppose A, and if so many forces are, n number of forces are acting, F1 and F2. So here the shear force at any point or section is defined as sum of the forces to the right or left of the section. So here I'll proceed from the right and I'll go to the left. So I'll take sum of forces acting to the right. And also here we have to take one sign convention. So when the shear force is going clockwise about a section, suppose if you take a section XX, and from that section, if a shear force is going clockwise direction, it is positive, and if it is going anti-clockwise direction, it is negative. And to give in a simple manner, or to discuss in simple manner, I will take here the shear force going downward as positive, because I am moving from right to left, so we'll see only we'll see in the right side. So simply in the shortcut way, I'll take the shear forces which are going downward are positive and upward as negative. So if you require the exact procedure, means the shear force is if it is the shear force is going clockwise direction, it is positive, or if it is going anti-clockwise direction, it is negative. So I told in our consideration in a simple manner, the shear force which is going downward is positive and going upward is negative. So this will be true when you move from right to left in that consideration only. So here just shear force at B means here shear force at B is nothing but 4 kilonewtons. So here this shear force is going up, so according to our consideration or sign convention, so it is a minus 4 kilonewtons going up negative, and value is 4. And next, shear force at C, sum of forces to the right, so to the right we have minus 4, and here a point load is acting at C, so this we have to take here, so and it is going downward, so it is plus 2. So minus 4 and plus 2 is minus 2 kilonewtons. And next, we require shear force at D. So the previous value means minus 4 plus 2 is minus 2, we got already, so here minus 2. And at D, point load is acting, that is acting downwards, so that is positive, so plus 4. So minus 2 plus 4 is plus 2 kilonewtons. And shear force at E, so it is plus 2 from the previous step, that is minus 4 plus 2 minus 2, minus 2 plus 4 is plus 2, we got. So from previous step it is plus 2 to the, means shear force to the right of E. And here at E, 2 kilonewtons is acting, that is point load acting at E, so we will take that. So it is plus 2 plus 2, it is plus 4 kilonewtons. And between E and A, no force is there, so shear force will continue between E and A. So and that value is 4 kilonewtons. And let us draw the shear force diagram here. So to draw that shear force diagram, let us take these points, dotted lines from this all key points, and here, so and draw a line to represent the length of the beam. And here before drawing, see here we have got shear force values minus and plus values. So we'll draw a line and we'll indicate positive values above the line, negative values below the line. So we have to draw a line such that we should get space for above and below. So I'm drawing the line here like this, and indicating the all key points here, A, E, D, C and B. And at B we got minus 4 kilonewtons shear force value, and it is a like point load, so it is all of sudden load. So we'll indicate with the vertical line here, point load, all of sudden load. So it is a minus, downward is minus, I told. So and B to C, no force is there, so it will continue up to C. And exactly at C we have 2 kilonewtons point load, so it is a positive value. So minus 4 to, it will become minus 2 because of addition of plus 2. And C and D, no force is there, so it will continue up to D. And at D, plus 4 kilonewtons is acting here, so it will become plus 2. So minus 2 to plus 2 here. So point load, all of sudden load, so we'll indicate with vertical line. So in D and E, no force is there, so the force will continue up to E, and at E we have point load that is 2 kilonewtons. So it's a indication is vertical line 2 kilonewtons, and from E and between E and A we don't have any force, so it will continue up to A, and you just close this diagram. So friends, if you see here, the shear force value at B is 4 kilonewtons, and this is negative side, so don't write once again minus. Anyway, we have taken this as a negative side, and this is a positive side. So it is 4 kilonewtons here, and here also 4 kilonewtons, and here it is 2 kilonewtons. Is a minus anyway. It is plus 2 kilonewtons, and here is a plus 4 kilonewtons, and here also it is plus 4 kilonewtons. And from this diagram, we can say that the force acting here, the 4 kilonewtons indicate the reaction force, that is 4 kilonewtons. So in our procedure, don't add this one, because we are coming from right to left. So at the last point, this 4 kilonewtons indicates the reaction force here. Or if you move from left to right, we don't take this, such that this force indicate the reaction force. So this is our method, and so by that we got the shear force diagram here, and we have to calculate next step, bending moment diagram. So to calculate bending moment diagram, we have to find out first of all bending moments at all these key points. So next step, calculate bending moments. To calculate bending moments, we have to calculate this here bending moments at each point. So first of all, let us calculate bending moment at B. So we know moment or bending moment is force multiplied by the distance. Suppose if you require bending moment at A and it is acting at some point B, so suppose this distance is R, if you take so if you want to moment or bending moment at A, so it is force multiplied by the perpendicular distance. This we know from the basics. So and here also let us define bending moment at any point or section. So sum of moments to the right or left of a section is nothing but bending moment at that point or section. And to take, and also we have to take here sign convention. Suppose if a force is bending or the beam or bending layers of beam in a upward direction, that is we'll take it as negative, that is nothing but hogging. And if a force is bending the beam or layers of beam downward direction, that is we'll take positive, that is sagging we'll take. So here at B we have force is there, that is 4 kilonewtons, that is point load, but we are calculating bending moment at B itself. So B to B distance is 0, so we'll get bending moment at B is 0, and towards right there is no beam or there is no load, so there is no loads or movements. So anyway, bending moment at B is 0 here. And next, bending moment at C we have to calculate. So to the right we have 4 kilonewtons, so this 4 kilonewtons will create sagging moment, that is positive. So plus 4 into distance is 1 here, so 4 into 1 is 4 kilonewton meter. And next, bending moment at D we have to calculate. So from the starting point, that is 4, this will create sagging positive. So plus 4 into distance is 1 plus 2, 3, and this is over, and 2 kilonewtons force is there, so it will create hogging, that is negative. So minus 2 into distance is 2 here, so this you'll get 4 into 3, 12, and this is 2 into 2, 4, 12 minus 4 is 8 kilonewton meter we'll get here. And next, bending moment at E we have to calculate. So from the starting point once again, so this 4 will create sagging moment about E. So force is plus 4 into distance is 1 plus 2, 3 plus 2, 5 here, and this 4, 2 kilonewtons is there, so it will create hogging, that is negative. Minus 2 into distance is 2 plus 2, 4. Next, this 4 kilonewtons is there, so it will create once again hogging, that is negative. So minus 4 into distance is 2 here. So if you see here, this is 4 into 5, 20, minus this is 8, minus this is 8. So this will get the value as 20 minus 16 is 4 kilonewton meter here. That is bending moment at E. And next we have to calculate bending moment at A. So bending moment at A, once again from the starting point. So this 4 will create sagging, that is positive. So plus 4 into distance is 1 plus 2, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 1, 6. And next, this 2 is there. So it will create hogging, that is negative. So minus 2 into distance is 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5. And next, this 4 is there. So it will create hogging, that is negative. So minus 4 into distance is 2 plus 1, 3. And next, this 2 is there, it will create once again hogging, that is negative. So minus 2 into distance is 1 here. So it is over, and if you calculate here, it is 4 into 6, 24 minus this is 10, this is 12 and this is minus 2. So it is plus 24 and this will be minus 24. So we will get here 0 as a bending moment at A. So this is the 0. And here let us draw the bending moment diagram here. So once again, take a dotted lines from all these key points. And also here, if you see, we got bending moments, all values are positive only. 0 plus 4 plus 8 plus 4, it is 0. So all values are plus only. So if you give above the space, it is enough. So just draw a line here to indicate the length of the beam and indicate key points here. A, E here, and it is D. C and it is B here, and at B we have 0, from 0 to 4. So this bending moment diagram we have to draw by taking the help of shear force diagram. So if you have shear force diagram as a horizontal line between two points, between those two same points we will get bending moment diagram as a vertical line. So if suppose if you have inclined line between two points in the bending shear force diagram, between those two same points we will get parabolic curve, but here inclined line is not there, so we'll get all, it means shear force diagram, though no inclined lines are there, so we'll get we got all vertical lines only. So in this diagram we'll get only inclined lines. So let us draw this bending moment diagram. So bending moment B is 0 and C is 4, and between these two points it is, you have horizontal line, so we'll get here inclined line. So here we have to indicate 4, suppose this much is 4, so 0 to 4 inclined line because it is horizontal. And next, 4 to 8 between C and D, so C and D horizontal, once again you will get inclined line. So this is 4, and 4 to 8 we have to draw. So suppose this much is 8, once again inclined line because this is horizontal, so this is 8. Next, 8 to 4, so you will get downward. 8 to 4 means you will get downward, so this is horizontal, you will get inclined here. So 4 means this much. So 8 to 4 is an inclined line. The inclined line is a 4. And once again, 4 to 0. Horizontal means here we will get once again inclined. So inclined, 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 inclined line, all inclined line. So 4 kilonewton meter, 8 kilonewton meter, and 4 kilonewton meter. So this is a positive, we have assumed the above the line is positive, below the line is negative. So if you require, you can just hatch this diagram to look in a better way. So this is the way to calculate or to draw shear force and bending moment diagrams for a given simply supported beam with all point loads. So for more videos, please subscribe and activate bell symbol. Please like it, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.